What's going on, folks? Ed Johnson here, Nerd News, show number 23, and I would just like to start off the show with a moment of silence for the children and the teachers that lost their lives at the school in Newtown. So we'll start now, and if you'd share this with me, I'd appreciate it. Yes, it is a ridiculously crazy thing. These things are happening way too often. I don't think I felt it as much as I felt it when it came to little boys and girls and selfless teachers. I not that I don't feel for the people that it happened to in the movie theater, the people that it happened to in the mall. I feel for everyone. But there's something else, especially around this time of year, when you have little five-year-olds. It's just a bad situation, and it's extremely unfortunate that it had to occur. So, let's get past that, if we at all can, and become capitalists again, and go through our ads and see who's sponsoring these shows. Best Buy, for all your electronic needs and DVDs and CDs. Are CDs available? Do you buy CDs anymore? I don't even know. I haven't bought anything in a very long time. But Best Buy, you're familiar with them. I'm familiar with them. Fandango, as I said before, you know you're going to need a ticket to get in to see any one of the trailers I'm about to talk to you about later on, along the lines of Man of Steel and Pacific Rim, so you might as well get your tickets here from my Fandango site, or my Fandango post on my site. Sideshow Collectibles, those wonderful busts and 12-inch figures that are extremely detailed and no longer toys, but works of art. Sideshow Collectibles. Gamefly, for that game you're questioning, you're not sure whether or not you want to buy, and or if you do buy it and then you regret buying it at $60 and then you go and try and trade it in and they only offer you $2 for a brand new game that you know you're going to see on the shelves again for $54.99. Pisses me off. I know it pisses others off. And lastly, T-Fury, the t-shirts that are available for the day, custom designed by you and others like you. That's right. Best Buy, Fandango, Sideshow Collectibles, and Gamefly and T-Fury are the guys that are bringing you the show for today. Let's go into our 10 and 10, last week's geeks. Let's go with number one. I have posted on my site, which the URL will be at the end of this video, live-action video by the team, Team 2X. They're at it again. You know that acrobatic martial arts team. They have a video up with Chun-Li from Street Fighter and Tifa from Final Fantasy fighting one another, and it's incredible. You know that these films, if you know who Team 2X are at all, they are amazing martial artists, amazing choreographed work. You've seen them in some films. So go check it out. It's great. It's a hot little movie. I think it's under four minutes. My number two is the fact that GTA Vice City has been released on the PSN network, and you can download it. It's one of the series. I think it's probably up there in the favorites column. If for nothing else, the soundtrack. It's the one where I think it's Tommy is the lead in that one. Tommy or Tony? I think it's Tommy, voiced by Ray Liotta? Ray Liotta. I'm going to say Ray Liotta. I'm pretty sure. I haven't played the game in quite a long time. But it happens down in Miami, Vice City. You're a gangster that just gets out and you're trying to turn your life around. And you go up against Colombian drug lords and cowboy politicians. And voiced by Burt Reynolds, by the way. Pretty good. I haven't played that game in a while. Maybe pull that thing out. So anyway, GTA is available on the PSN network. If you recall, it was exclusive to the Xbox and Xbox only. Another side note along the lines of video games, the Halo 4 Crimson Map Pack has been released, which will give you three new maps. I hear that they're huge. I haven't downloaded them yet, but I hear they're huge. There's one where vehicles are the predominant fighting option on one. I think it's Shatter. I'm not sure. I haven't really looked at them. That was my number 2. My number 3 is Defiance. I have a video of the developer's diary, and they're talking about the convergence of both the multiplayer, the MMO game that they're about to release, which is a third-person shooter MMO, which will combine itself with a show that's being released on the Sci-Fi Network by the same name. You're going to be in San Francisco in the game, and I think the show happens in another part of the country, but some of your actions in the game will actually affect the show. I'm not sure how they're going to do that yet, but it's a consistent world where even if you're not playing, things are happening to your character. So, number 4 is the Phantom Pain video, which is a trailer for a game that wasn't really expressed as to what it was. It debuted on the VGAs last week, and it was a soldier, obviously, who had been injured, and he awakes in this hospital, and all crazy shit's starting to go on. You don't know whether or not he's hallucinating from drugs or if things are really happening, but there are soldiers that are destroying the patients in the hospital by, you know, the dozen. So, the rumor has it now is that that is actually a trailer for the new Metal Gear game. So if you haven't seen it, go to the site and check that out. It's a pretty good video. It blew my mind. I thought it was pretty awesome. And now that I find out that it may be in connection to Metal Gear, it might just revive that series for me, because I've lost interest in that series. Once you stop playing Snake and they brought in the other guy and got too flippin'... sorry, too confusing. It got too confusing. I stopped playing it because it just got too confusing. Number 5 is trailer for Oblivion with Tom Cruise. Apparently, from what I'm gathering, Earth is done for. We've colonized other places. But he's maybe a scavenger of trying to figure out what it is that happened. I don't get too much. If you haven't seen the trailer, this is a spoiler, but... Once you see Morgan Freeman, I lost interest. It was pretty weak already. I have a bad taste in my mouth with Tom Cruise's take on the Invaders from Mars. I thought that was really vanilla, and this movie looks pretty vanilla too. And then you put Morgan Freeman in it, and it just becomes just... I mean, I only like Morgan Freeman in the Chris Nolan movies, okay? So let's put it that way. As Lucius Fox. My number 6 is, that was Oblivion. My number 7 is the trailer for After Earth, which is the latest M. Night Shyamalan Ding Dong's attempt at a film starring Will Smith and his son, Jaden. They are apparently going to train on a planet where everything has been designed to destroy human beings. Turns out at the end of the trailer, spoiler, if you haven't seen the trailer, 1, 2, 3. That planet that they're on is Earth. It doesn't look like Earth, it looks like a jungle, and that's where they've crash landed. So, I'm a big fan of Will Smith's, and it looks visually stimulating. I may just go check it out, but I promised myself I wouldn't see another M. Night movie. I might see this one. Probably not. Probably won't see it. No more. You will not have any more of my money. Number 7 was After Earth, and number 8 is the trailer for The Lone Ranger. Let me put it to you this way. Johnny Depp is Captain Jack Sparrow as an Indian, and it's a Jerry Bruckheimer movie. You've seen it. Watch Wild Wild West and Pirates of the Caribbean, any one of them, and you've seen this film. That's what I'm assuming. That's what you get from the trailer. I hate contemporary themes in period pieces. Don't give me contemporary lines in period movies. I hate when they do it. I hate it in The Three Musketeers, although I didn't see it, but I hate when they do that in those movies. So, Lone Ranger trailer, check it out. It's down there. I'll let you be the judge. You may like it, who knows? It might as well have been directed by Michael Bay, for all I'm concerned, and you know how I feel about Michael Bay. Number 9 is the Pacific Rim trailer. If you've been living under a rock, you didn't know that it was coming out last week, and it did, and it looks amazing. It's giant robots fighting against giant monsters, and it's directed by Guillermo del Toro, and he's one of my favorite directors. I love his visual style. I called him the modern-day Tim Burton, and if you're gonna deny, you're not gonna agree with that, but you have to acknowledge when I met Tim Burton. Tim Burton, the first movies for me with Tim Burton were back in the mid '80s. You know, Edward Scissorhands, Batman. You know, those kinds of films, and nothing like that had been done. So all of that theatrics coming out was really beautiful and not unheard of. So I think that Guillermo del Toro, not mirroring that, but along the same lines, he has a visual eye of stuff that I've not seen before, and I'm not seeing from other directors, and that's what I mean by that. I had an argument with another nerd friend of mine, and I just before you guys start hitting me with any emails along those lines of that. So anyway, Pacific Rim was amazing. The trailer looks awesome. God, this video is really flat, and I apologize for that. The thing in Connecticut really is bothering me. Blah, blah, blah. Pacific Rim. I would have preferred the trailer without the voiceover. The voiceover makes it slightly weaker, and it takes a little bit away from it. So I would if you watch that trailer, watch it with the voiceover and then turn the volume down and see what you think. I think it's better without the voiceover. And the only reason that at all paled in comparison is that a day before the Man of Steel, the new Superman movie's trailer came out. And although the first trailer was a decent trailer, it looked, I mean, I can't really describe it in any other word other than quaint. It was quaint. You know, it looked like a trailer for The Deadliest Catch. Although it looked good, it just didn't show anything epic. And I was afraid that we were going to get another Superman movie where he was just, you know, pouting and moody, and then he fights, you know, some comedic villain like Lex Luthor. But from this trailer, you absolutely understand that this is going to be epic. The damage, there are Kryptonian ships, Zod looks amazing. He's getting thrown into vault walls, and, you know, he's flying at supersonic speeds. He's making stuff just, like, move underneath of him. It looks like a superhero film, and I'm excited to see it. I think that Zack Snyder, with the, as my friend Conrad said, with the guidance of Christopher Nolan, will be able to rein in all of that geek love that he has and make a focused, linear film. And I think that that's what this is going to be, aside from that Sucker Punch movie and that ridiculousness of that. And again, visually great, stupid fucking movie. But Man of Steel doesn't look like that, at least not from the trailer and the way it was cut. It looks amazing, and that's my number 10. A couple of honorary mentions. There's another video with Guillermo del Toro that on my site where he's on Harry Knowles' show, Ain't It Cool News, and he's doing a Q&A about the Pacific Rim trailer, and he's expressing himself as to what he was thinking and how he made the film and how he cast the film. It's pretty interesting. And there was another, but I can't recall what it was that I wanted to mention to you, so fuck it. That's it. It's a quick show. Wasn't sure I was going to do one after the stuff that happened. Didn't feel right, but I'm trying to push these out on a regular basis, I promised, to others. So that's it. I'm going to keep it short. That was Nerd News, show number 23. Again, my condolences to the families that have to go through what they're going through out there in Connecticut, and no family should have to deal with the loss of a child, especially around Christmas.